Welcome to another video, and today we're gonna talk about 50 things you didn't know about Valorant. Some of these things are useless, but some of these things you can use in game. I want to thank everyone for the support on part 1 and part 2. It's insane, man. I can't believe it got so many views, so thank you so much. These things are getting harder and harder to find, so I also want to thank everyone in my Discord server who came up with some of these things. If you want to join, link is in the description. We almost got 1,000 members, and honestly, guys, you guys are just changing my life. Like, a half year ago I was no one, so thank you all for the support. And before we go into the video, I'm very excited to talk about the sponsor of this video, Blitz.gg. Blitz is an amazing app which analyzes your games, shows your stats, and offers you guides. It has everything you need to improve in Valorant. This is how the app looks like. Here you can see that my kill death ratio is below the 1, and my win loss ratio is extremely low. Yeah, I played really bad this season. What I really like about this app is this graph. Here you can see your shot percentages. A good headshot ratio is around 27%. So by looking at this, I know that I really need to work on my aim. You can also see your agent stats, weapon stats, and win-loss ratio on every map. I always say that Split's my least favorite map, and now I know why. I got a 29% win rate on that map. Like, how is it so low? Now that I know this information, I know that I really need to improve on this map. Luckily, Blitz can help me with that. When you go to the map section, you can select the map. And of course, we're gonna select Split. Here, you can select an agent. Now you see a lot of tricks with that agent on this map. How sick is that? You will find lineups, setups and other tricks, all in videos in less than 30 seconds. I get way too excited, but this app cuts everything and it's completely free. So download it now if you want to improve in Valorant. A link to their site is in the description. Now, let's hop into the video. You can hide Killjoy or Nanos from behind this box. When the enemies are planting the bomb, they cannot see it, so you can activate it, easy peasy. If you use your gateway before you used your Yoru ult, you can spam that ability to teleport back instantly without getting hit. On Haven A there's a sniper and a jar sitting in the corner. This is a reference to the game Team Fortress 2. In that game the sniper agent used the jar of piss as a weapon. Yeah, it's a very strange game, but it was fun back in the day. If you look in the minimap while running in Valorant, you see a circle. That circle indicates from how far away the enemies can hear you. What a lot of people don't know is that that circle is exactly the same range as the spike explosion range. There are a lot of cute plushies in Valorant, but at Wines on Ascent you see all the plushies at one place. You can spot the bunny, the bear, the worm, the squirrel and the penguin. When making this video, I've been looking at the sack for over 10 minutes. What is the red stuff on the sack? Is it blood? Is it paint? What is it? Well, if you look closely, it's a teacup. It's probably tea. Wow. I want to congratulate Paul for being the employee of the month. Paul. On Icebox there are some jumps that not everyone knows you can make. The first one is over here. The second one over here. You can also jump back. You can jump on this box. And this last one I know thanks to Headset Gaming. If you use the rope you can also jump on this box over here. You will have to practice this though. According to the lore there's Radiant in these green boxes. They say that Radiant is very powerful. If you look over here, you see that only one box terraformed a whole mountain behind it. But of course, this is only a speculation. Maybe those mountains were there already. Who knows? When you shoot on the wall, you can see if you shoot through the wall. The hole will get a little bit bigger. If you want an easier way to look if you shot through the wall, you have to buy the Nerf gun. With this skin, you see only the Nerf bullets when they don't go through the wall. When you are wallbanging, not only the material matters, but also the angle from where you are shooting at. In the background you see a small demonstration. Is it just me, or does this statue look a little bit like Gyarados with hands? If you are defusing the bomb, you can see at the top corner how much time you had left if you either won or lost the round. In this round, my girlfriend lost with 0.01 second left. I mean, it's possible. I don't know how, but it's possible. 0.01 seconds. People in my stream are saying that I should stop destroying snowmen because they are cute. But if you look at this wall on Icebox, you see no snowmen. So I'm doing something good. Destroying the snowmen is very important. You can destroy the glass on Icebox with every smoke in the game. This can be useful if you, for example, want to push glass later with Omen. Just use the smoke at the start of the round, easy peasy. In the train station on Split, there are a few couches people can sit on. On the backside of the train station, the couches are floating very high. Very, very practical. How to Noodle will always be flying. So if you take away this bug, he will find another way. And he did. You have to do exactly the same, only now you have to jump at the end. And you will be flying like How to Noodle. Credits to him for finding this. If you are in your Yoru ult and you jump off the map in the range, you can walk on the bottom of the map. Honestly, I got like 50 comments saying this. So thank you for the 50 people who said this. If you look over here in Split, you see a few Valorant Funkos. This might be a secret advertisement and they will release it in the future. I will definitely buy one. If you want to use your shrouded step while in the smoke, you can look at the minimap where your shrouded step is gonna land. This way you don't accidentally teleport in front of an enemy. This sushi bar and split got nice faces on it. This really made me hungry. With Omen, if you smoke over there, and then smoke over here, then you can do a sneaky shrouded step play to nest. Easy kills. If you like this video this far, please consider liking, it really helps growing my channel. Thank you. Someone from my Discord channel said that if you place your boom build over here, the door opens. This trick is insane, like what? Not sure if he found it out, but Jelly, thank you for this trick, man. If you use the Yoru footsteps through the teleporter, it makes the normal sound. Sadly, the footsteps also open the door, so the enemies standing in hookah will know it's a fake teleport. But you can counter this. At the start of the round, use your footstep like this. This way, when the footsteps walk through the teleporter, the enemy will hear the teleport, but the door won't open. If you right-click your footsteps on this spot at the start of the round, you can do this from anywhere. For example, if you rotate back to B, you can fake the teleporter from there. Again, shout out to Headset Gaming for this trick. In the last video, I went all the way to the top of that building in Split. But people said that you could walk on the mountain on Icebox. So here my journey begins. And without a joke, it looks way closer than it is. I think it took like 15 minutes to get on top of the mountain, but eventually we got there. And the view is okay, I guess. But can we walk over here? Yes, we can. That's pretty cool. It's very useless, but it's cool, I guess. But you can also walk on top of this highway in Split. I think this is a cool spot to get headshot battles, you know? Going only for the headshot crouching. And you can also walk over there in Ascent. This is also a good place for a 1v1. In Lamps on Bind, you can only wallbang through this part of this wall. Very cool, very cool. With Sofa, you can jump higher if you jump during your Sofa ult. The last shot will get you even higher when you aim at the ground. You can use this to get on top of some things. As everyone knows, I like breaking stuff. And I thought that I had to find everything you can break in Valorant. Someone in my Discord found another bottle. It's over here, you can break this bottle. Finally, I can sleep at night now. The background over there is not 3D, by the way. It's 2D. Brimstone is the only agent where a single ability can be lethal to himself. His Q and his ultimate. And no, the race grenade is not lethal to herself if you only use the grenade. If you throw your gun over here, you cannot get it back. This can be useful if you don't want the enemies to save a gun. If your teammate dies, for example, just throw your gun out of the map and the enemy cannot save it. The frog on this map got a nice head. This head looks a lot like Teemo's head. Oh no, he is also in this game. If you are very cool, you can jump over Razor ult. Last player standing. It does not matter from how far you are falling. If you time your satchel correctly, you will not take fall damage. And don't look at all the bodies on the ground. I mean, it was my first time. I did it in my first try. Sofa has an artificial right eye. With that eye, he can see what his drone is seeing, like you see in the clip in the background. His fingers are against that artificial eye. On Split, the boards over here give the same information as the boards over here. I think it's a bit overkill how many boards with information there are on Split. When Icebox first got released, this was not broken at all. But in the cinematic at the start of episode 2, you saw this explode, and now it's broken. If you want to rotate from yellow box to A site, it's faster to rotate like this, through the ropes, than all the way around. This route will take you 19 seconds, and this route will take you 21 seconds. I mean, it's only 2 seconds, but you know, it's better quick than sorry, you know? Oh yeah, you can also stand on the boat over here. Very cool, very cool. The sound of the full diffuse sounds different than the sound on the half diffuse. You can hear this in the background. And now when it's half, it's a little bit a higher pitch. I got this beautiful knowledge from Ekwik, so credits to him. The face on Killjoy's turret is pure decoration. Underneath the turret there's a sensor, that's how the turret can see the enemies. Or scan the enemies. There's a gravity on Bind that we all wish wasn't there in the world. I guess. And the last one, you can make a clad roll with the sheriff if both enemies have armor. Whoa! Okay. Well, this is the end of the video. If you like this video, please consider liking and subscribing. It really helps growing my channel. And I see you in the next one. Peace.